different setup now than some of my other videos, testing and learning a new camera. And I'm going to be sharing here on the screen with screen recording as well. So gives me the opportunity to be a little bit more creative with my editing and jump it back into regularly making these tutorials and hot tip videos for you. Let me know in the comments below if there's a particular video that you're interested in. I have a lot of your frequently asked questions and videos coming to you soon. Again, my name is Patricia Regier. And I would appreciate a like and subscribe. Less than 1% of you subscribe. I know a lot of you, we are over 500,000 views, watch our videos, and we get the views, but we don't always get the subscriptions. And this helps YouTube bring these videos to more people that can benefit from these tutorials. Now, back to this video. I am going to share about Canva, a hot tip. When you're in a design and you want to edit something, so you may even want to search in elements, arrow, and you might want something that is moving and put that there, or you have a picture. There's a little symbol here off to the right for some quick actions. So instead of always having to click the picture and then edit the picture and then get to the Magic Studio, like for example, often I will use the background remover. So let's try that with this one. Edit, image, background remover. And for some pictures in a presentation or for a design for your training materials or social media content, that is very helpful. But when I go to a video or a picture, could be a video clip, and I want to, instead of go to edit image in a couple clicks, I can also go to this little grouping of stars in the bottom right, and it's quick actions. And it will bring me directly to some of the magic options. Like I can show more, I can search if there's something that you want, like the background eraser where you're just wanting to remove one item, or it will give me magic edit, where if I want to remove something in the background here, I can just paint it and then what I want to do, color blue or inspire me, generate. So that's how you quickly get to some of these magic items, is that little magic in the background. This is interesting. Look like marble. So anyways, yeah, let's try it. So that's changing something in the background. How cool is that? Now I also want to find that quick edit again, and I want to grab and I want to click, and these are pro features. If you see the little crown in any of my tutorials and there's a little crown beside an item, that is a paid Canva Pro account feature as well. When a comment recently was asking about that, so I will definitely create a video and reply with details. So the grab is not coming up. Some of these others are. Let's try it this way. So I wonder if, because grab text, I can do that. Okay, so interesting. This is a great tip. You saw it working, but if it doesn't work for you, you can click edit image up here and magic grab and grab. So what's really neat is if I publish my second book, I could maybe theoretically swap out the book in that. So with Magic Grab, I can move that out and put a new one in there. So it's pretty exciting what you can do with the Magic features. And then of course, too, at any point, you can undo. And then it looks right. So the reason why I hopped on is because of this quick actions off to the lower right that you can grab one of those magic features with a click of a button and select one of these, even blur any of these options. You can, instead of multiple clicks and trying to search, you can do that right there. Hope you find this shortcut helpful about Canva Pro magic features and this quick actions option here off to the right. Thanks again for checking this out. My name is Patricia Regier.